In the music world, no name shone brighter or for as long as Quincy Jones. He's one of the very few performers to have won Emmy, Grammy, Oscar and Tony Awards. He's an EGOT. The legendary producer passed away this week, aged 91, after seven decades helping create some of the greatest music of our times and a soundtrack to our lives.
When the Quincy Jones magic met Michael Jackson's talent, Thriller, still the world's all-time biggest selling album, had Quincy Jones's fingerprints all over it.
I believe that he and Michael argued about things, which is what you want in the studio. You want confrontation and discussion, but of course the result was just magic.
Quincy wanted a smash hit single with a feel like the Knack's My Sharona. Michael already had his demo.
One, two, three, four.
Quincy turned it into this.
You know, putting a song like Beat It on Thriller, that Michael didn't really want at first, but he said, come on, we need a rock song. And then getting Eddie Van Halen to play the guitar solo, I mean, they were breaking all sorts of barriers there.
Quincy Delight Jones Jr., born in 1933, grew up on the mean streets of Chicago.
I wanted to be a gangster till I was 11.
Wow.
You want to be what you see.
Right.
And that's all we ever saw.
Thankfully, he chose music instead. Learned to play the trumpet, played in clubs at 14. The rest, as they say.
I've been in this business 70 years. It's unbelievable.
It starts in the late 1950s with a job at Mercury Records, putting those musical fingerprints on work by established superstars like Ella Fitzgerald, Peggy Lee, and Leslie Gore. It's my party and I cry if I want to, cry if I want to, cry if I want to. Then came his longest running collaboration.
I would like to have you meet a gentleman who's been doing these marvelous orchestrations for me, Mr. Quincy Jones. Right there.
Fly me to the moon. Let me play up there with those stars.
A friendship and working relationship that lasted 40 years and was literally out of this world.
The astronauts on Apollo 10 took a little tape recorder along with them and they played that tune back to Earth from about 150,000 miles in space.
We're ready.
Frank called up when they played that music on the moon. He was like a little kid. You believe that? And I said, no, man. The first music on the moon? Give me a break, man.
From jazz to pop and everything in between.
He's fundamental to modern music from the get-go.
His genius knew no bounds.
The world's number one music man, one would think that's enough. What made you decide to go and produce a film?
Well, it's been a little secret dream for years, Ray.
It was a dream debut too. The film was nominated for 11 Oscars. It's called The Color Purple. But it was music that kept driving him.
Back on the block, back on the block. Ice tea, let me kick my credentials. A young player bred in South Central.
Back on the block, Quincy Jones, producer Quincy Jones.
He was nominated for 79 Grammys and won 27. Mostly for helping others make the most of their talents. Who else could call the world's biggest stars to be backup singers for Donna Summer?
We went out and got, for the choir, James Ingram, Christopher Cross, Michael McDonald, Stevie Wonder, Lionel Richie, Michael Jackson, Kenny Loggins, and Dionne Warwick. And then it was a day I'll never forget. We filmed it that day. It was just unbelievable. Everybody showed up, too.
His ability to harness the greatest musical acts on the planet helped in 1985.
One, two.
We are the world. We are the children.
When he made more music history.
Where Quincy just was a dude, you know.
Sir Bob Geldof was there.
I probably did the last interview with him a couple of months ago, and he was so cool. And I was always aware that I was in the presence of proper, pure, gold-plated, copper-bottom musical genius, and that's always the go-to for me.
Presidents called him a force for good and the great unifier. That's what Quincy Jones called music.
I've seen the power of music as a tool to reach the hearts and minds of millions of people.
A true great has left the stage aged 91.
If you've been listening to God's Mighty Trumpet recently, you'll have noticed it got a little better in the last few days. If you've been listening to the Heavenly Choir of Angels, finally they're in tune, because somebody who knows what they're doing is up there, you know.
God bless you, man.
God bless you. This is what an experience.
Keep on keeping on.